Hello and welcome to my channel Happy Learning to You, your ultimate guide to easy learning. Today let's continue with the topic on plant kingdom, and today's video will deal with pteridophytes, the third category of plant kingdom. In this part, I have discussed about the characteristics of pteridophytes. In part 2, I will explain about reproduction and classification of pteridophytes. So let's begin quickly. So the characteristics of pteridophytes here, they are found growing in cool, damp and shady places, but some may flourish well in sandy soil conditions. Pteridophytes include horsetail and ferns. These are also the first terrestrial plants to possess the vascular tissues, basically the xylem and phloem. Coming to its uses, they are used for medicinal purposes, as soil binders and also as ornamentals. Now, the main plant body in case of pteridophyte is a sporophyte. If you remember, in case of the previous category, that is the bryophyte, the main plant body was gametophyte. So in this case, it is sporophyte. The sporophyte is differentiated into true root, stem and leaves. The leaves here may be small, wherein they are known as microphylls. Example is Selaginella. Or the leaves may be large in size, wherein they are known as macrophylls. Example is ferns. Now, the sporophyte bears sporangia, which is subtended by leaf-like appendages, which are known as sporophylls. In some cases, these sporophylls may form distinct compact structures, which is known as strobili or cones. Now, the sporangia produces spores by means of meiosis in the spore mother cells, which then germinate to produce inconspicuous, small, multicellular, free-living and mostly photosynthetic thalloid gametophyte, which is known as prothallus. Now, what do you mean by inconspicuous? Basically, which is not easily noticed. This is the definition of inconspicuous. Next. Now, the gametophyte requires following. It requires cool, damp and shady places to grow and water for fertilization. And because of these conditions, for its growth, the spread of a living pteridophyte is limited to narrow geographical regions. Well, this is all under the characteristics of pteridophytes. As I've told you, my next video will deal with reproduction and classification of pteridophytes. Do press like if you could learn about the characteristics of pteridophytes in an easy way. Post in your comments and do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.